Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. I know I don't get to doing these very often right now. Maybe I'll get back into a routine. But I know this week will be a little challenging. I have a funeral to do on Wednesday. But amidst this season of COVID that seems to be never-ending, and likely will and has introduced changes to how we conduct this thing called life, it's not all bad, right? I know some days are easier than others in dealing with social distancing, and unfortunately that social distancing sometimes feels like God is practicing his own social distancing with us. Like, what's the deal, right? At a time when we most need him. At least that's how it can feel. But this can be a time to reflect on what our prayer practices have been and what they can be like. I know I've been pondering a lot recently about the nature of God as listener. Yeah. Psalm 66, verses 19 and 20. I just love and have been going back to them a lot recently. The psalmist says, God has surely heard. Yep. He has attended to the sound of my prayer. Blessed be God, who has not rejected my prayer or withheld from me his loving devotion. Those are beautiful words. Throughout Scripture, there's constant referencing of God hearing the prayers and the cries of his children, and that God is grieved by the injustices he sees here on earth. God responds by healing, bringing rain and righteousness and love. God does listen. I mean, look at the life of Jesus, right? God with us, God incarnate, God taking the form of a human being is the ultimate act, I believe, of God listening, of wanting to enter into our human situation and circumstances and to sit with us, if you will, in the dust of the earth, the chaos of our circumstances. Jesus did that. God did that with us. The very act of God becoming human, sharing with us in a very personal manner, God is wanting to know what it is that we feel inside and to experience it from our perspective. That is God in Christ. Interesting thing about listening, it often has more power to have someone feel less lonely when they just listen. Somehow, people sense a deeper connectedness when you're just listening to each other rather than just having this jabber back and forth. Henry Nouwen wrote a book entitled Out of Solitude. And he said this: when we honestly ask ourselves which people in our lives we feel closest to, it's often not those who give us advice or offer solutions or cures, but rather it's those who offer instead a willingness to just share our pain and to touch our wounds with a deep and caring spirit. A friend is one who's silent with us. I do believe that. Who's silent with us in a moment of despair or confusion. And who stays with us in our hour of grief, right? A friend is one who can tolerate not knowing, not curing, not healing, but just sit with us and face the reality of what is sometimes simply our powerlessness. That is a true friend. I think of those people in our lives who we may not see for years, but when needed, they come, right? And they just sit with us. They don't pepper us with a bunch of questions of what's bothering us. They don't need to know the details of our grief. No, no. Their love for us is enough. And they simply see our pain. And they listen. A great sign of a close relationship is just being with each other in their presence, wordlessly knowing each other's joy and each other's pain. Henry Nouwen said in the book, Out of Solitude, he said, most of the time, the people we most love we feel safe around them. They are the ones who don't give us the easy answers and the quick fixes. They're the ones who simply sit and listen with us in the dust, in the Bible. We discover a God who listens. But we cannot deny that feeling that sometimes God just feels distant. You know, where are you, God? God, can you heal me? And eventually the questions become, can you even see me? Can you hear me? And God's silence can feel like the absence of his presence. It can. But I do believe if you listen closely enough and follow God's lead, you will hear deep within your soul, my son, my daughter, I so love you. That's it. I love you. It's not experiencing a God who offers pat answers or cures or offers the quick fixes. No. It's the God who's the friend of your soul, who wants us to know that likely, even if he did say something to us, likely it wouldn't make sense to us anyway. But God does want us to know. He's always sitting with us, right in life's dust, listening. You know, it's kind of counterintuitive. You know, instead of feeling God's absence at such moments, it's in his silence his nearness is felt. Not having the answers you want is exactly what we need to understand how much he loves us. Loneliness comes from not necessarily being alone physically. Loneliness often comes from just not being heard. And it can come from, loneliness can come from disagreement between people. I mean, people perhaps in your family or your church, you don't understand your perspective, your theology, your understanding of God, your understanding of relationships, of culture, of race, of politics. And when you're not heard, it can be lonely. In every church I've been in, that loneliness raises its head for me. I'll be honest. I'm not and never have been, nor ever will be, someone who rubber stamps the beliefs of others. When I get to know the predominant flow of the stream in the church, I tend to go against the current. It's kind of how I'm wired. I want people to think through why they believe what they believe. And I want to challenge them to try to see things from a perspective other than simply their own. Defenses, though, often go up. I mean, I'd never say that your way of thinking is wrong. Only you can make that kind of assessment and own it. None of us have cornered the truth. But sadly, in these days, many act as if they have. And the result? Loneliness. Because people, they're not hearing one another. They're just taking sides. When you base your associations and your relationships upon being with those who believe like you, I truly believe such an endeavor is fruitless. It's a myopic existence where it's your beliefs and your opinions taking center stage rather than God and the beauty of relationships. I've seen this firsthand in every church I've been in. This church is no exception. People just end relationships over belief systems and opinions. And things get taken so personally. It's as if God just gets pushed out of the equation. And all you have left is your opinion. All you have left is your choice of having your opinion befriend you more than another human being. I find that sad. I can assure you, your opinion, whatever it may be on whatever subject, is a cold bedfellow who offers little to no warmth, only the cold, calculating, sad, and bitter existence of your version of the truth. People value these days being right or being on the winning side more than they do relationships. And the fallout loneliness. Loneliness stems not only from not being heard and respected, it also just comes from confusion. The uncertainty of what the future holds. And there's a lot of uncertainty these days. But there's good news. Though I've felt lonely, and others, many of you have also, I don't know about you, but I've been feeling closer to God more than ever. It's as if He keeps reminding me I'm not alone. Never have been. God is there listening and sitting with each of us. If we'll just listen. Prayer is the ability to look into God's eyes and know He's looking back at you. Prayer is less about information transference or polite dialogue. It's about the movement of empathy from heaven to earth and the slaying of loneliness within us. Kurt Thompson, a psychologist, wrote a book entitled The Anatomy of the Soul. And he said words like this. He said, an important part of how people change is through the process of telling their stories to an empathetic listener. When a person tells their story and is truly heard and understood, one sense of emotional and relational connectedness grows strong. There's a greater awareness and compassion for the other's suffering that takes hold. It's a beautiful thing. Prayer is about the movement of empathy from heaven to earth and the slaying of loneliness within the deepest part of our soul. Prayer is looking into God's eyes, looking into ours. It's about listening. I'm going to end with a little poem. I'm still writing it. It's in progress. But I'd like to end with it. As I felt God's presence sitting with me in my loneliness and reminding me I'm not alone. So I want you to position yourself in a comfortable place right now. Open yourself up to God. As I pray this poem that's in progress right now, I'm still writing it. As I pray it over you, and I guess it's appropriate that's in progress because our lives are in progress, right? Always, always. So here's what I have for it so far. Never alone. Never any breath alone. Never a thought or quiver alone. Of any kind. Never a beat or a pulse or love for any human soul alone. Alone is impossible. Alone is death. But even then, it's not alone. Alone would be to live without the womb, a divine oxygen surrounding the human spark of life. there can be no alone, not even for one's enemy, not even for emptiness itself. Vast, torn separation, there cannot be alone. There is no space not filled with divine presence. The envelope of breath's creation. Alone is uncultured imagination, built to shelter human shame, trying to slay its human maker. Yet so, never alone. That's all I have so far. May you go in grace and peace, knowing silence isn't absence. It's the presence of empathy and compassion that is God sitting with you in the dust of your unanswered questions. May you feel God's love as his eyes gaze upon you, looking at him. God looking at you as an act of prayer and communion. Amen. God bless you. Peace be with you always. I love you guys. Life is beautiful. It is good. Please remember, please, you're never alone.